Oh, scratch that whole thing. Blah, beep. Hey guys, it's Andrea from AndreaVeggie.com. If you've been hanging out for a minute, then you probably know that me and my friend Angela went on a Groupon tour to China. Before we went, we researched all about things that we should know before we got there, but nothing really replaced being in the country. So today I wanted to add to that information for you if you're deciding to go to China and tell you 15 essential things that you need to know before you visit China. The first thing you need to know before you visit China is that their restrooms are different. So basically, we have toilets that you sit on. They have toilets that you squat over. It's almost like a hole in the ground. A lot of companies are working on getting rid of that style, but there's still a lot there. So that's kind of something to be warned about before you go. Don't wear your fanciest shoes. They're gonna get dirty. I don't know how else to say that. The other thing about Chinese restrooms is that very few of them, if any, had toilet paper in them. So make sure that you either bring toilet paper with you or steal some from your hotel. So probably shouldn't be advising that, but make sure you bring some out. With you go out and about for the day, make sure you bring a roll of toilet paper with you because they won't have it in the restrooms. The next big thing to know is that China is all about cash. So their whole economy operates on cash. So I kind of made this mistake. I hardly ever bring cash with me when I go places. I know that's bad. I know I should, but I just forget. I was like, my card doesn't have foreign transaction fees. It's fine. Make sure you get Chinese cash before you go, or you can change it when you're there at the airport or at the hotel. They should be able to take your American dollars and flip them, but be careful because I had $100 in American cash and $60 of it got turned down because of like tiny little blemishes on it. So I would probably, your best bet is to get it changed before you go. For those wondering how I manage the no cash thing, I was able to find a Chinese ATM where I could withdraw with my credit card. I don't know how bad the fees were. I chose not to look, but I needed cash. So that's just learn from my mistake, bring some cash. The third thing to know is that lines in China don't really exist. It doesn't take super long to realize that Chinese definition of manners and our definition of manners are just really different. It just comes from being in a different culture. So Angela and I were kind of confused at the airport because nobody was like waiting in line for the bags and like at restaurants, nobody waits in line. You just kind of start making your way to the front. Don't be shocked like we were, that's just what they do. And so just kind of follow the lead with everybody else. Don't be shocked if there aren't lines because there's probably not gonna be. So the fourth thing you should know is to not drink the tap water. Most tap water in China isn't safe to drink, so just make sure you go ahead and grab a bottle of water, or if you're at a restaurant, they'll likely serve you like a cup of water, but it'll be hot. I think this is because locals carry tea bags with them, and so they like to make their tea in the restaurant, but make sure that if you're gonna drink cold water, it's out of a bottle. The fifth thing to know is that the smog in China is real. So if you're worried about wearing a mask and looking like a tourist, you won't. Locals wear a mask. It'll just help a lot with breathing in unclean air. By the end of the day, when we didn't wear a mask, we were all kind of feeling sort of sick and just congested. So I highly recommend wearing a mask because it will help a lot with that smog. The sixth thing to know is to prepare for selfies. So as a Westerner in China, everybody and their dad will want a photo with you. We were so shocked by this at first, but by the end of the trip, we got used to it. So just, yeah, whenever you get over there, prepare for the fact that almost everybody will want to take a selfie with you. And like, you might get pointed at and laughed at, but you know what? It's just, you're living your life. It's fine. You'll be fine. The seventh big thing we're talking about is VPN. So in China, websites like Google and YouTube and Instagram and Facebook are all blocked. So if you want to use those while you're there, you're gonna wanna download a VPN on your phone before you go. We used ExpressVPN and didn't have a problem. The service in China wasn't great. The Wi-Fi wasn't phenomenal, but it was like good enough to post and to text and do those sorts of things. So you're gonna wanna do that if you wanna use those sites. When it comes to cell phone service in China, I have Sprint and Angela has T-Mobile. Both of those companies offer free international data. I think it's free international low speed data and like free text, no calls. So we were both able to get on our phones fairly decently while we were out on the bus. It wasn't like great service, but it wasn't horrible. Definitely enough to text our parents. So if you're traveling to China, if you have Sprint or T-Mobile, you're in luck. If you don't, you might have to put it in airplane mode. I'm not sure you're gonna wanna contact your carrier about the rates that they have for international data and texts. The eighth thing to know is you need a visa to go. Don't go to China without getting your visa. they won't let you in. The way me and Angela got our visas is we sent our passports to a woman in Chicago who kind of does like a visa, Chinese visa business, where she'll take it to the consulate in Chicago and drop it off and then pick it up for you and then mail it back for like a fee. So you need all kinds of stuff. Make sure you read up on how to do it. I might make a video about it if you're wondering. So let me know in the comments if that's something you'd want. But basically, don't go to China without getting your visa. You need to start getting it about 3 months in advance. The ninth thing we're talking about is Mandarin. So everybody in China speaks Mandarin, Chinese Mandarin. That's their national language. But very few people speak English, and there's hardly any English signs or literature or really anything. Before you go, make sure you're downloading Google Translate, and then go ahead and do like the thing where you download the actual thing to your phone. That way you're not needing service to operate it. And that'll come in handy with restaurants and just directions, asking anybody for anything. It'll just be really handy thing to have. So I would definitely download Google Translate before you go. Number 10 is to bargain. If you're at a market, make sure you bargain. Almost everything in China is negotiable. They're giving you higher prices because they're expecting you to bargain. So make sure you go ahead and do that. No offer is offensive, really. Obviously use your head, but yeah, they're expecting you to bargain there. The only places you don't really bargain are like actual stores with price tags and restaurants. It's pretty easy to tell when it's time to bargain and when it's not, so just go ahead and use your best judgment on that, and I'm sure you'll be fine. The 11th thing to know before you go is where you are staying. So like I said, there's not much English in China, so it's important to know where you're staying in English and Chinese before you leave. So a lot of hotels will have these little like business cards, and it'll say like, my Chinese residence is in English, and then it'll give the Chinese address, and you can just show your cab driver that, and he should be able to take you right to your place. So make sure you grab one of those before you leave the hotel if you're planning on taking a taxi back, because it'd be pretty bad if you got out of the city and then you're like, bring me back to my hotel, and they don't know where that is because they don't speak English. So make sure you grab one of those cards from your hotel, and if they don't have them, just ask the concierge or the front desk person, and they'll be happy to make you one. Number 12 is easy. They don't tip in China. So at the restaurants, don't leave a tip. You're not expected to leave a tip. Nobody tips in China. 13 kind of goes with the restaurant thing, is that they don't have anything but chopsticks in China. So if you're like me and you don't know how to use chopsticks before you go, you're gonna have to learn, because you won't eat if you don't use chopsticks. So that's just something to know ahead of time. The 14th thing is to please, please, please be careful as a pedestrian. You'll likely be walking places, and the roads in Beijing and Shanghai are crazy. So there's like 8 lanes of traffic, rickshaws, scooters, walkers, and you're just kind of like, poof. So follow the traffic signs and then pay attention to where the scooters are. I heard that if you're walking, they're expecting you to keep going. So don't stop for them, because they're timing it based off you. So keep going and just please stay alert as possible, and you should be fine. The 15th and final thing is to carry your passport with you, or like a copy of it. A lot of places in China use it as a ticket. So for example, for the Forbidden City, we had to give our passports to the front desk person to get the ticket. So just make sure you have it with you so you can get into places like that. That's all I have for you. There's nothing that beats actually going to China and seeing it in person. And I could talk about it till I'm blue in the face, but seriously, like, there's nothing that compares to actually being there. So if you take a trip to China, please let me know. I'd love to hear about it in the comments. If you guys like these videos, go ahead and like and subscribe. I'd be super honored if you did. Let me know if you have any topics that you want to hear about travel-wise or Etsy-wise. I love making these, so I'd be happy to hear your feedback. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you soon.